you just sit back down? Oh, she was. So, Deb, I'm an idiot.
That's mine?
Good evening, and welcome to Channel 12's live broadcast of Waynesville High School Lady Tiger Soccer. I'm Nelson Morgan, and it is my pleasure to bring you this game on cable channel 12. Our opponent tonight, the Parkview Lady Vikings. This game is important for multiple reasons, twofold especially, as this is an Ozark Conference game and also a Class 4 District 9 contest, as far as preparing for the seedings in the upcoming district tournament. Starting lineups are being introduced for Parkview. The Lady Vikings are 4-5 on the season, and they are 2-1 in Ozark Conference play. And they are tied with Waynesville right now in district play. The Lady Tigers also 1-1. This game will go a long way to decide who is going to probably get the number 2 seed in the Class 4 District 9 tournament. Lebanon and Springfield Central also in that tournament. And Central has won its first two games, defeating both Parkview and Waynesville. Lebanon has lost its first two games to Parkview and Waynesville. And so very important that Waynesville managed to defeat Parkview here this evening. Lady Tigers now being introduced, starting for the Lady Tigers. First of all, in goal, Deanna Hasek. Deanna is a senior. Also starting for Waynesville, Alexis Willingham, a senior midfielder on her way to play soccer at William Woods next year. Emma Kirsten, a sophomore midfielder. Reagan Mertz, wearing number 8. Reagan is a junior. She's playing a left defender this evening. Caitlin Sieber is a senior, playing at a forward position. Raina Watterson, who has recovered from some injury situations, was able to play in the last couple games, and Raina will be starting at defender, center back. She is a junior. Nina Grace Rodriguez, a senior forward. Emily Lucid, a senior defender. And Lindsay Seacrest, a senior defender. Also, Sierra Zadrovich is going to be playing at midfield this evening. She is a sophomore. And I believe I mentioned Zena Thompson. Zena is not going to be starting tonight. Zena will be replaced up front by Caitlin Sieber. Courtney Chartier is going to start at the right outside wing position. Sierra Zadrovich moving to the left outside wing position for Waynesville tonight. Lady Tigers on the south end of the field. Lady Vikings on the north end. And from the way the Lady Tigers are lining up, I would say that it's going to be a kickoff for Parkview to start this game. Three officials. One in the center, and then two linesmen. And Parkview will be kicking off. That's Ellie Tate and Alyssa Laird, I believe, at midfield for the kickoff. 40-minute halves in high school soccer. And if you've not seen the girls play this year, Waynesville needs to have a pretty productive night offensively. They have not been able to find the back of the net much this year. So the kickoff goes, and it is now Parkview with it on the far side. Ball's out of bounds, belongs to Waynesville. Throwing it in for the Lady Tigers, Reagan Mertz. Most of the throw-ins will be done by the wingbacks. These teams in 4-4-2 sets, but a little bit different in the back. Waynesville with a flat four, and Parkview with three backs, and then a sweeper back. You don't see too many sweepers anymore. That's kind of out of vogue, but they're using it here tonight. So a foul against Waynesville, and the direct kick was taken. It was relatively short. The Lady Tigers get it back. That is Willingham serving the ball down the left sideline. Out of bounds. Coming back in on the throw for Parkview. The Lady Tigers playing at the Tiger Stadium. This field is marked for both soccer and football. So if you're watching the game and unfamiliar with the sport of soccer, the yard lines actually mean nothing in the game of soccer, but it does help you to kind of keep track of how far a play might have gone in that way. Nice move coming down the sideline. This is Courtney Chartier fighting for the ball, looking to cross it in on the ground, and it's covered by Aaliyah Buckley, the goalkeeper for Springfield Parkview. Courtney Chartier was a late addition to the starting lineup, as Zena Thompson unable to play tonight, so Coach Mike Gow made some changes just about 20 minutes ago. Bringing it in, Reagan Mertz. Ball is picked off by Parkview. Lady Tigers need to maintain possession of the ball in the midfield. They've had a little bit of trouble doing that this year. And if you can't maintain possession, you cannot advance it to the attacking third. Again, there's a throw in from Parkview. Picked up by Zadrovic. Then cleared way downfield by Parkview. Going after it, this is Watterson. I'm sure she's on the field playing. I believe she had a concussion earlier in the season that cost her several game opportunities. And we all have learned the importance of concussions, that we have learned more and more about them, I should say, over the years. And in all sports, much more caution is being taken, and that is a very appropriate thing. Throw in coming up for Parkview. Longland stepping up with the ball. That was Watterson going in, trying to put a foot on it. Lindsay Seacrest. This is Zadovich, and her line pass intended for Caitlin Sieber out of bounds. So we'll have a throw in. There it comes. Parkview with it. Kind of a wild kick down towards the corner, and it's going to be knocked across the end line. Be a goal kick coming out. Ball will be placed on the six box. And taking the goal kick for Waynesville, Emily Lucet. Emily's a fine defender from Waynesville. She just recently signed to play softball at one of the school, Westminster, I believe, in Fulton. Mike Gow helps out a little bit there by playing the ball. Out of bounds, of course. Long inbounds throw, and it's Watterson. She's making her presence known now that she's back in the lineup. We've called her name, and we've seen her involved several times. Ball kicked out of bounds by Parkview. Most of the action on the far side of the field. We haven't seen either team switch to the near side with their possession. Ball is knocked free down to Deanna Hasek, Lady Tiger goalkeeper. She has 91 saves this year. She's allowed 24 goals, 79.1% save average, and 2.4 goals per game. Ball's going to go across the end line on the far end off of one of the Lady Tigers. So it's going to be a goal kick coming out for Springfield Parkview. Parkview in brand new uniforms. They're very attractive. They're black and gold. I was talking to the assistant coach before the junior varsity game, and he said they were really excited to have them. The school's colors are green and gold. The uniforms are black and gold with a green numbers over the gold. Pretty sharp looking. Waynesville with the basketball, listen to me, Emma Kirsten. I should know better than that. Still think I'm at the basketball tournament in Sedalia, I suppose. On the far side, this is Mertz again. 2-3 touch, now she wants to drop the ball back, played it forward. Loose ball. Picked up by Parkview, and then a wild pass. Didn't help anybody. Just chasing it down. You want to try and connect your passes. You want to get your passes to the feet of somebody on your team. Then you can be productive. That was a fairly nice cross, but nobody could do anything about it, and Waynesville alertly came up and got rid of the soccer ball. Now the Tigers have possession. That's Sieber with it. Zadrovich trying to control it with a battle on the far side. This is Waterson again. Chasing it out of bounds. It'll belong to the Parkview Lady Vikings. Throw in, opportunity. And it's Zadrovich picking it up. Stolen away from her. As you can see, we talked a little bit earlier about maintaining possession of the ball. And so many times we're just kind of losing it there. And it's not just the Lady Tigers. Look at that punt. Look at that punt by Deanna Hassick. She has such a strong leg. But both Waynesville and Parkview unable to maintain any kind of possession at the midfield. Chasing after the ball, Zadrovich, and I believe she's got the speed to beat this girl. But her pass goes to Parkview, and Lady Vikings just knocked the ball away. That was for Parkview. Whoa. Number three. I don't even see a number three on the roster. We'll have to look. With it there at her feet, Lindsay Sechrist. Lindsay's going to be playing college soccer next year at Hannibal LaGrange College. And that's the alma mater for assistant coach Jesse Grossfeiner. Jesse played soccer here at Waynesville and also at Hannibal LaGrange. JV won earlier tonight, looked very, very good in doing so, defeated Parkview 2-0, and I think JV is now 5-3 on the season. Pretty good little ball club, fun to watch. Lady Tigers trying to maintain possession. That's Emily Lucet looking up the pass. They work the ball. Waterson, when you kick it right off of the opponent's shins, it's going to come right back at you. Your pass has to go away from them. And we're going to have a foul on the Parkview as they ran right up the back of Lady Tiger on the far side. That was Reagan Mertz. Reagan's brother's in the other booth over here. He's running the video camera for Coach Mike Gow. And he plays boys soccer in the fall. Ball's just kind of being kicked around out there. Somebody needs to maintain possession of it and complete a series of passes and advance it, preferably if you're in orange and white. Here's Willingham. Willingham will be playing college soccer also next year at William Woods College in Fulton. So she's off and running now. She's a pretty good athlete. Nice pass up to Nina Grace Rodriguez. And the ball is going to go out of bounds, but was it out off of Waynesville or off of the goalkeeper? Okay, it's off of the Tigers. And it did not go out of bounds. They're going to say that Aaliyah Buckley grabbed the ball before it crossed the line. The ball has to be totally across the line, either the sideline or the end line. It has to be totally across the line to be considered out of bounds. Here is Zadrovich with a nice run down the left side. She's trying to find somebody. Cross coming in, looking for Sieber, but it's picked off by Springfield Parkview. Waterson. Loose ball. Gathered in. With it now. This is Emma Kirsten. Kirsten trying to maintain possession, get possession. Sieber. Looking. She's found Rodriguez, and Rodriguez can't control it, and it goes out of bounds. It'll be a goal kick coming out. We have about 11 minutes and 15 seconds elapsed in the game. You can see the time at the bottom of your screen. 40-minute halves for varsity soccer in high school. Nice ball sent up forward. That was Courtney Chartier. She is, I believe, a transfer player, a sophomore. Nice ball, nice drop pass, nice drop pass. Now let's do something with it over there. This is Reagan Mertz. There's the ball, trying to find the ball there. This is Lucet. Lindsay Sechrist looking for someone on the sideline. Pass is picked off by Parkview. Lucet again and out of bounds. I believe it's going to, are they going to call a corner kick or are they making substitutions there? Making some substitutions. Somebody's coming in for the Lady Tigers. And I think that is Christina Zabek, number 23. Christina's a real solid offensive player. She can do a lot of things with the ball at her feet. Ball comes down and it's handled easily by Deanna Hasek. Hassett carries it out. She'll take it to the top of the 18. And a nice punt once again to the 45-yard line of the other side of the field on the football markings. As I said, that helps a little bit sometimes to gauge how far things go. Mertz passing it up. Finds Willingham. Willingham now looking inside, Emma Kirsten. Kirsten on the right side. It's picked up by Zabek. Zabek with a nice pass forward. Here we're going to Nina Grace Rodriguez. Cross going down and then just didn't get enough angle on it. It goes out of bounds off of the Lady Tigers' last touch. So it was a nice attack. It was taking shape. And what we want to see is a little bit more of that. Get down there and take some shots. Pass is, or the, not the pass, but the inbounds kick is not a very good one. Lady Tigers able to maintain possession of it. There it is, Sieber. Her shot right off of the stomach of one of the defenders. Now it's Zabek on the right side. She cuts back. I told you she had moves. There it is, a header, and it's misdirected and out of bounds. Tigers are a very first really solid scoring opportunity. They'll pull back. It'll be a goal kick. There's a big widescreen view. It's a beautiful view from up here as you look down through the valley and the West Waynesville. And it's been fun this spring as we've watched all the trees changing color and blooming and everything. Lots of beauty in our little community. Ball's out of bounds off of Waynesville. Waiting for the ball person. There we go. Okay. Lady Tigers provide two ball people running the sidelines, and they have a ball with them, and that helps to maintain the speed of the game, the continuance of the game, I should say. There's no timeouts in soccer unless there's an injury on the field, and then the official has the right to stop the clock, or if there's a red card, or if a goal is scored. And that's what we want right now, but the ball's out of bounds. Last touch by the Lady Tigers. Being inbounded. Nice throw. But Watterson steps up. She thwarts the possession opportunity, but it goes out of bounds off her foot, so Parkview gets it back anyway. No score. There's your one of your ball girls. This Parkview player can really throw the ball extremely well. Going down to the corner with it. This is Ellie Tate. You know, she wanted to cross, but it's going to go out of bounds. It's last touch by Waynesville. It's going to be a corner kick. Corner kick for the Parkview Lady Vikings. This is a scoring opportunity. It is a set play. And taking the corner kick for Parkview is going to be Maya Flores. She's a center back, and a lot of times your backs have strong legs, and they come and take the corner kicks. There is the kick, and it went right through the middle of everything and all the way to the other side of the field, as it does so often. When you have really strong, tall forwards, if you can get that corner kick right in front of the goal, then you can score a lot of goals off of headers. And Lady Tigers had at one time in school history were able to do that, as Katie Pritchard was tremendous in front of the goal. And I believe it was Tasha Lard that was sending the corner kicks in. Possession to Parkview on the throw-in. There it is. Disrupted by Mertz. No possession there. Sieber. The header. Mertz trying to maintain possession on the sideline. She can't, so it'll belong to Parkview. Last touched off of Mertz, and we're going to have another corner kick. This time off the other side. If the ball goes across the end line off of the defending team, then the attacking team gets the corner kick, as you're watching take shape here. If it goes out of bounds off of the attacking team, then you place the ball on that black line down there at the feet of the several of the players, and the defending team can kick it out. That's the goal kick. And that's not what you want to see on a corner kick, because you want to keep the ball in play, and she kicked the ball out of bounds behind the goal net. So a break for the Lady Tigers, but certainly did not help Parkview when it had a scoring opportunity. Emily Lucet taking the goal kick coming out off of one of the Parkview players. That's Ellie Tate once again. Tate is a senior. So she knows the ropes. She wants to get that ball and try to put it in the back of the net. Throw in for Parkview. Good throw off one of the heads of the Lady Tigers. Here's Watterson. Nice pick for her. On the give and go, she's got it up. Looking to Siebert. Siebert down the left sideline. Pushing it, pushing it, pushing it. She's going to get it in the crowd here. Yep. As the ball was, she was double teamed and could not get rid of the ball in time, and Parkview took possession. Now it's loose again. Parkview with kind of a wild kick, and it goes to Waynesville's Lindsay Seacrest. She moves it up to Alexis Willingham. Willingham, now this is Zabek with it. She can push it, she can push it, and make a good cross. Here we go. There it is. Nice, nice ball. Out of bounds. Nope, still in play. Still in play. Willingham. There's a shot coming. Watterson. Oh, too high, too high. If you noticed, Watterson, when she took her shot, her shoulders went back. When your shoulders go back, your foot's going to get underneath the ball, and you're going to get that lift. You don't want that when you're that close to the goal. Nice move by Willingham, though, as she saw her teammate open and drop the ball back to her. Sometimes in soccer, you have to go backwards in order to go forwards. Goal kick coming out for Parkview. Off the head of Willingham. Loose ball kicked away. For Waynesville, it's Watterson. Now Zadrovic. Willingham. Down the far sideline. As I said, we have had very little action on this near sideline. Siebert. Siebert to Kirsten. Emma Kirsten with a nice little run. The girls have to learn when the run is over. And they have to recognize it earlier so that they can complete a pass before the defense shuts them down. Long sideline kick. It's Waynesville's ball. Watterson. Once again, here is Sechrist. Zabek. Off and running. This is down the right sideline. Look at her go. Look at her go. They're not going to shut her down. Her cross comes off of a defender right back to her. There is another one. Headed out by Parkview. Waynesville fans are enjoying that. Lots of screaming going on down there. Sechrist. Sechrist pushes the ball up, looking for Zabek. She's got her. Now Kirsten. Kirsten with a good quick pass to Watterson. Watterson trying to keep the ball alive on the far side. Zadovich. Now we're seeing some good passing going on. Willingham. I believe that's Zadovich once again. Nope. That was out of my range. Kirsten. Kirsten to Zabek. Zabek's got her girl beat again. Now this is Willingham. This could be a good 1-2 punch. She turns on it. Nice cross. And out of bounds off of one of the Lady Tigers. It'll be a corner or a goal kick coming back. Under 17 minutes to play in the opening half. As I said, this is an important game in Class 4 District 9. The winner of this game will most likely, get the second seed in the tournament. Springfield Central has enhanced its opportunities, and they are already 2-0 in district play, and their only opponent left to play is Lebanon, and Lebanon has lost both of its games. Not to say that the Lady Jackets couldn't win and upset the apple cart, but Central seems to be in the driver's seat right now. The important game is this one right here. The winner most likely a 2 seed come district time. Districts, I believe, will be played in Lebanon this year. And they might be playing it on the high school stadium. When we went down there and played, we played at the stadium. They had marked the football field for soccer. This field is professionally marked. It was all done at the time that the field was laid out. But I believe they had to paint the football field at Lebanon in order to get the soccer lines put down. Zadovich on the throw in. And should be a foul from behind. That was Daisy Brown came in on the back of Alexis Willingham. So we have a direct kick, a push is a foul, and a direct kick opportunity. Zadovich with a good leg and a good kick. And there it is in front of the goal. Can somebody do something with it? This is Kirsten. Kirsten looking for Zabek. Zabek's got one to beat. She cuts back. Here it is, left-footed in the middle. Willingham wants to get something on it. She does. It's a weak shot. There's a shot. Goal! 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 Waynesville! Nina Grace Rodriguez for the Lady Tigers at the 14-41 mark. And the Lady Tigers go up here. And it was, you know, it was Zabek bringing that ball down and initially making that cross, and then Willingham got in on it and shoved it forward, and Rodriguez scored for Waynesville. And I believe that is her first goal of the season. There's a foul against one of the Lady Tigers. Parkview near midfield. Oh, I guess that was... They must have kicked. That was the kickoff is what that was. Somebody had kicked it too soon, and they were redoing it. Here's Willingham. She can dance with the ball at her feet, too. Watterson. Willingham on the near sideline. In the middle, finding Kirsten. Now Watterson back to the middle. Here is Siebert. Siebert's ball off the foot of one of the defenders. Back out there with it for Waynesville. That is Jessica Dwyer, who is now in the game. We missed her when she came onto the field. She is a freshman. I believe she is the only freshman that is on the varsity this year. Solid player. Story I'm told was that during tryouts, some of the returning varsity players visited with Coach and said, Coach, this one needs to be with us. And she is. And I know that Coach Mike Gow is very pleased with her efforts so far. Here's Zabek. Pushes it past her defender. A little bit of a give and go there with Rodriguez. There's a nice cross, and the goalkeeper comes out and mishandles the ball, but picks it up off the ground. And you saw, I think that was Kirsten coming down the middle. Boy, I tell you what, if they can get it in their heads that any time the ball goes to the goalkeeper, you rush that keeper. A lot of times in high school soccer, the keeper two touches the ball. And when that ball is in between touch one and touch two, you can nail it and find the back of the net. So one of the Lady Tigers had it in mind to do just that. It's going to be a throw-in. Delaney Baker for the visitors. Zadovich to Dwyer. This is Dwyer now, taking off down the sideline on the far side in front of the visitors' bench and losing it out of bounds. Throwing it into the left of your screen. Now towards the center of the screen, you can see the Parkview player. It's not that cold. Somebody's all wrapped up in a blanket over there. Ball's kicked away. Waynesville fighting for control. And this is Lucet. Nine times out of the ten, she goes into a battle one-on-one. She's going to be the one coming out with it. There's Dwyer with a nice quick pass to Willingham. Willingham controls it, drops it back. Watterson. Now up to Siebert. Siebert left-footed. Up front, Dwyer. Nope, couldn't get the ball to her. It's knocked away by the defender, the right back. Parkview uses a sweeper system. Number 15 is a defender behind the other defenders. And she has the freedom. It's for her, it's not necessarily a zone coverage. For her, she just basically goes where the ball is. Long ball coming back into play. Lucet. And the shot is going to go wide left. So, goal kick coming for Waynesville. Again, it's Lucet that's going to be taking it in the zero jersey. Deanna Hasek. A senior, both of these girls, I believe, seniors. Nice goal kick. Nice goal kick. Way out there. Lady Tigers have possession now. Pass forward for Rodriguez. Got past her. She's tripped up, but no foul. I think she went down herself. Here's Zabek with the ball. And I'm not sure whether she wanted to take a shot or make a cross. But she did not turn her hips, did not come around on the ball, and it went out of bounds the direction she was facing. If you wanted to go right or left, you have to turn those hips and redirect the ball. Loose picked up there by Katrina Jones. She's the right back for the Vikings. Sieber on the give and go, and it's out of bounds. Parkview will inbound it once again. Lady Tigers up 1-0 over Springfield Parkview. Under 10 minutes to go in the first half. Almost a must win for the Lady Tigers. Would certainly enhance their opportunities for a 2-seed come district time. Would also move their record to 3-2, a winning record in Ozark Conference play. Loose ball, Picking it up, here's Zabek. She stumbles, she shoots, and it's saved. Aaliyah Buckley. Ball was shot right at her, a little high. She went up, sure hands. She brought it back down. Try to go wide. Try to go wide with your shots, because that's where the goalkeeper ain't. Shoot them where they ain't. Ball in the back. They're going to control it. This is Sechrist. Working it up the left sideline. Zadovich has the ball picked. Ellie Tate takes it away from her. Tate loses it out of bounds. It'll be Waynesville on the throw in. You can see the setting sun coming in on your screen. You get a high camera view, and that sun's really going to reflect. One thing about Tiger Stadium, you absolutely see some beautiful sunsets up here. If you've never been to Tiger Stadium, the new stadium here at Waynesville High School, strongly suggest that you come and enjoy a soccer game or a football game next fall. And once we get the track fixed, maybe a track meet as well. By the way, speaking of soccer, Lady Tigers are here again tomorrow night. It is a girls varsity game only. Varsity only. Hazelwood Central from North St. Louis County will be here in town. They've made the run down here about 7 or 8 years in a row now. And here's Zabek. Here's Zabek. She almost let that girl shut her down. She beat her. Now she lost possession. You see, when the one girl, when the Parkview defender began to come out on her, she lost her passing angle. Kirsten loses control of the ball. When you're open, that's when you have your best passing angle, your best cross, your best shot. Anytime the defense begins to cut down on your angle, come in close to you, it's usually too late. There's Rodriguez with the ball. She loses it, gets it right back, finds Zabek. Zabek with a nice pass left side to Willingham, picked off, but Willingham picks it up again, and she's going to take a long shot, will go out of bounds. Off of a defender, out of our screen's view. So it's going to be a corner kick for Waynesville.
And we have a corner kick for Waynesville.
And it's going to be Zabek. Christina Zabek taking the kick. What she wants to do is get the ball up in the air, just right about in the middle of the goal. A little short, knocked out of bounds by a defender. It'll be another corner kick for the Lady Tigers. Now this might be a different play. Okay. Sierra Zadovich is going to take the corner kick. It's always good to have your forwards and your attacking players like Zabek in front of the goal. Zadovich is going to wait for her teammate to get there. That's a nice one. That's a nice one, but it was too far across the line. You saw that it hit the side net. Had pretty decent distance, but the angle was off. And so it's going to be a goal kick coming out. Wasted opportunity. Corner kicks are great scoring opportunities. Notice that Maya Flores carries the ball over to the far side for the goal kick. You're allowed to do that. You can place it anywhere you want on that black line or within the goal box. There's a foul. I heard a whistle. And it's going to be against Parkview, so Waynesville will have the kicking opportunity. And it looks like Sierra Zadovich is going to set it up. The other girls know that she can reach them, and they're going to move downfield probably 20, 30 yards. She's got her hand up. Here it is. I'm coming, and that's it. Loose ball. Off of the post, off of the left post, and was not touched by one of the defenders. Boy, that that had some distance on it. Off the left post and out of bounds. Goal kick coming up. We're nearing the 4-minute mark of the first half. Here comes our Parkview player putting the foot into the ball. It's headed back. Kicked back by Waynesville. Now this is, I think, Kirsten fighting for possession. Sieber. Parkview manages to get to the ball and kick it long. Lucet battling against Tate. Lucet drops it back. Nice play there by Lindsay Sechrist as she finds Dwyer on the sideline. Off of Delaney Baker. So the throw in for Waynesville. And then it's going to go back the other way. A lot of back and forth in soccer if you don't maintain possession of the ball. If both teams tend to lose the ball from their feet. Oh, this is a foul. This is a foul. Did not see who it was on. Probably a direct kick as it's up high. And looks like Ashton Pills fighting for the ball there. I think it was number 36 into the game. Yep. She's a junior. Played a lot of goalkeeper, JV goalkeeper last year, but we really don't need a goalkeeper this year with Deanna Hasek, a senior. Goal kick coming out. And we have a substitute coming in. Anyway, Ashton has been playing a lot in the field. She's had some starts. And I'm trying to figure out who that is that just came onto the field. I guess it was Willingham that came back in. Lucet, goal kick. Lady Tigers just kind of let that ball go, and Parkview kicked at it. Need to rush these balls and take possession of them. Don't let the other guys get it first. Under 2 minutes to go. Be a 10-minute intermission. If you're not familiar with soccer, at halftime it's a 10-minute break. And Sechrist going to make the throw. And waiting for another substitute to come on. This is Molly Henry. Molly, I believe, is a junior. Missed most of last season after transferring from Camdenton because of knee surgery. You'll see the heavy brace that she wears. Molly's in number 25. Sechrist trying to get the ball from Alyssa Laird. Loose in the middle of the field now. This is Watterson. Watterson to Emma Kirsten. Loose ball, Kirsten. There you see your sprint. There you see what needs to do. What needs to happen is chase after that ball. And down in a far line. Out of bounds off of Waynesville. So a goal kick coming out. Sometimes goalkeepers themselves take the goal kicks, but in both of the instances of these two teams, they choose to have a defender take the goal kick because if the kick is not a good one, it can come right back into the goal mouth, and you want that goalkeeper in there. And they're having the countdown now. And that's the end of the at Tiger Stadium. Waynesville leading Parkview 1-0 on a goal by Nina Grace Rodriguez with 14 minutes and 41 seconds remaining in the half. For Rodriguez, that was her first goal of the season. It's a difficult thing to admit, but the Lady Tigers have only had five. And the leading scorer for Waynesville is a five-way tie with one, as Rodriguez has scored here today. Sierra Zadovich has a goal. Christina Zabek has scored. Caitlin Sieber has a goal. And Alexis Willingham has a goal. So we need a little bit more punch. We certainly do. And I think that you can see it. Some of the things in the first half, if you maintain possession and you get down in what's called the attacking third of the field, where you can take some shots on the goal mouth, then good things can happen, as it did on the Lady Tigers' goal. So we're going to take a break here during the 10-minute timeout, and we'll be back with exciting second-half action after this. Tiger Stadium, Nelson Morgan. And it's a pleasure to be working with Tim Wallace, the R6 district programmer for Channel 12 TV production, and his crew this evening. Lady Tigers leading Springfield Parkview 1-0, and it's going to be Waynesville's kickoff to start the second half of play. Brad Meister is our center official, and did not have his name at the first half. The linesmen for the game are Sam Orr and Ken Sire, and they are very familiar to Waynesville soccer fans, and Waynesville is familiar to those too. They are here quite a bit, but Brad Meister is the gentleman calling the game in the center. And you can see him out there, whistle, and there it is. Lady Tigers with a kickoff. It was Molly Henry. And it's quickly captured by Springfield Parkview, coming back the other way. This is Kirsten Watterson. Watterson passes the ball back up. Nice left-footed pass, but there wasn't anybody there. And so Parkview kicks the ball down. Ellie Tate, pretty good soccer player. And she battles for it very well down at the far end. Sieber. Sieber drops the ball back. And that's Lindsay Sechrist with the ball at her feet. Now Willingham. Still in possession. Waynesville on the far side. Down the far sideline. This is Christina Zabek. And she runs into a wall of... wall of one, I should say. She went down, lost possession of the ball. She needs to learn to get rid of the ball quicker. She's very confident in her abilities, but she needs to recognize when the other team is going to shut her down and get rid of it. Loose ball. Somebody's limping over there. Is that Kirsten? No, we're waiting. Oh, they're bringing, that's Emma Kirsten that's limping. They're bringing her out of the game, and coming back into it, I think, is Nina Grace Rodriguez. So that we may see some realignment out there. They have Molly Henry at one of the forward positions. And Rodriguez, Molly Henry at the left forward, Rodriguez at the right forward. Inbounds throw in. Siebert trying to maintain control. Watterson chasing after it is Lindsay Sechrist. Long throw and lost out of bounds. That first touch is oh so important in soccer. When we mean first touch, it's as the ball comes to you to take control. And if you don't have good first touch, then the ball is going to go off one direction or the other. And if you're marked tightly by a defender, then you're most likely going to lose possession. There's a shot on a nice cross, but a weak shot by Alyssa Laird. And it is covered by Waynesville's Deanna Hassick. I think that's their second shot on goal. No, first shot on goal, second shot. Watterson, right side. Siebert. Siebert with a nice left-footed pass. She connects with Willingham. Willingham with a pass drop. Back to Siebert. Off the chest of one of the Tigers. Loose ball. As Parkview fails to maintain control of it. And on the left side, it's Siebert. Now to Zabek. Zabek down the sideline. She sends it in. She did a good job there, but there was nobody there to grab it. And the ball was out of bounds anyway, so you're going to see the throw in. She made the cross from out of bounds. Off Waynesville. Here comes the second throw in. Long one over everybody's head. Going over to collect it for Waynesville, Sierra Zadovich. And again, it's another throw in for Parkview. You see a lot of throw-ins in games where you've got two teams that really do not maintain possession of the ball very well. Good play by Deanna Hassick as she rushed out to scoop up the ball. Goalkeeper, of course, the only player that can use their hands on the field of play. A throw-in is not considered the field of play as you're throwing it in from outside. Here's Watterson. Watterson to Sieber. Now Willingham. This is on the near side. Zadovich, nice pass up. Coming to collect it is the freshman, Jessica Dwyer. Watterson, send it back again. Siebert, Watterson. The two of them are being kept busy by a single defender, and it ought not to be that way. Spread out a little bit. If you manage to maintain possession at a distance, then it makes it very difficult for the defense to do anything about it. There's a definite foul. This one's going to be on Delaney Baker. And the Lady Tigers will have a direct kick coming from just across the center line. Emily Lucet to take it. And it's kind of a low kick, bouncing. Parkview knocks it loose, out of bounds. Waynesville soccer ball. Short throw in. Zabek controls it off of the chest. Now reaches out with a good move. Keeps the ball in her possession. There she comes with it. Nice touch. Redirected and out of bounds on the near post. I think that was Henry with the direction touch shot. So we're going to have a corner goal kick. Maya Flores taking it for Parkview. Parkview is 4-5 on the season in 9 games. Lady Tigers are 3-7. So if we can manage to maintain our lead in this game, we'll at least have as many wins as them. We'll be 4-7. They'll be 4-6. But even more important, we'll be 3-2 in the Ozark Conference, and Parkview will be 2-1. Rolla and Camdenton are currently tied for first place in the Ozark Conference. Both of them are 4-0. Of course, the Lady Tigers lost to Camdenton on the road Tuesday night in a game that was over in about 2.5 minutes as the Lady Lakers put 3 in the net before you could sit down and put your hand on your popcorn. So the those two, Rolla and Camdenton, are in first place. And then you have Parkview, actually, and Kickapoo and Glendale. Now, that's an unusual threesome for the three of those teams to be mentioned in the same breath. They are all tied for third place with 2-1 records. Sixth place is Waynesville at 2-2. Seventh place, Joplin is 0-1. There's a ball that's going to go out of bounds off of Waynesville, so it'll be a goal kick coming out. Joplin has only played one conference game. They lost it, so they are 0-1. Tied for eighth place, we have Hillcrest and Lebanon. Both are 0-3, and bringing up the rear. And 10th place is West Plains, 0-4. The Lady Zizzers have struggled a lot for a long time. And they are winless in conference play again this year. Here's Zadrovich. And a foul. Foul going to be against Parkview. It'll belong to Waynesville. Who's going to come over? No. No, I'm sorry. It's on Waynesville. It's going to belong to Parkview. You see the Waynesville girls making a wall there. Coming over to take this is Emma Hampton. She's a freshman. It's a good one. It's a good one. A little short, though. Had good angle, but not enough distance. Two parts to every pass, every shot. Is angle and distance. Doesn't make any difference what style, what type you're talking about. You've got to have those two things to make it work. Nice run by Zabek. She comes into the middle to Alexis Willingham. And all the way down close to the penalty box. Shot. Nope, it's blocked away. Siebert is going to knock the ball out of bounds. And there's an offsides call. Offsides call. If you saw the official in the extreme right-hand side of your screen, he had his hands on his hips. And that was an indication of an offsides. We're going to have checking out a player. I think that's a junior varsity player that's in for them. Number three, Kayleen Rendon, is a freshman. But she's going to stay in the game. She's going to stay in the game. The clock is still running. The official has not stopped anything. But the ball is placed at the point of the offside. The point and the location, the center, right, or left side of the field where the offsides call was made. Willingham loses the ball out of bounds. Lost the ball to the opponent. And now Parkview trying to maintain possession. See, they have troubles with that as well. Perhaps even more so than the Lady Tigers here tonight. This is Zadarich. Nice split pass as she connected with Watterson between two defenders on the far sideline at Zabek. They just can't stay with her. She's beaten one, and she loses control of that on the touch. It's knocked out of bounds by a defender. So Waynesville maintains possession. It'll be a throw-in. Going to give it to Watterson to throw it in. She's on the Waynesville side of the midfield line. Tapping it around. This is Willingham. Left-footed. Slots it through. And do we have another offside? I think it's going to be another offside call the way the official is holding his flag over there. So somebody was too far deep when the ball was advanced. Soccer offside is very difficult to explain, but once you've played the game or familiar with it, then it's easy to see and easy to understand. There's a shot that was put up, by Sieber. Went wide left, and it was way short anyway. Aaliyah Buckley comes out with it. She punts the ball away. She did not get a good foot on it. She caught the ball on the inside of her foot and did not get a very good distance on it at all. This is Jessica Dwyer battling for possession. Should be Waynesville on the throw-in. Yes. Zadarich. Zadarich is dangerous down here. She can put the thing deep. So let's see how the girls handle it. There it is. There it is. Out almost in front. Off the header off of Rodriguez. Now Waynesville's going to chase it down there. Christina Zabek. And the ball's being kicked back and forth. Parkview says, here, you have it. Waynesville says, no, you can take it this time. And then, oh, no, you can have it back. And so we... going to kick the ball out of bounds and start everything over again with a throw-in. Maintaining possession with the ball, Ellie Tate. Off Waynesville, out of bounds. Parkview to throw it back in. 1-0, Lady Tigers. On the strength of a goal by Nina Grace Rodriguez, her first of the season. Transfer student, I believe she's from Texas. And she's got her first Missouri goal. There's Zadarich. Clears it out. Henry trying to chase it down. The defense got to it first. Willingham. Willingham looking to Dwyer. Dwyer on the run down the sideline. She's got two girls trying to pin her in. She has a nice little cross, but just not enough distance on it. A little short. Goes out of bounds, and we're going to have a corner kick. Corner kick, Waynesville. Good stuff can happen here. Good stuff can happen. And taking this corner kick is going to be Zadrovich. Dwyer's right down the middle of the mix. You don't see any other Lady Tigers. That's because they all have assigned runs. Nice ball, little bit low, little bit low. Kicked out of bounds. And when you have assigned runs and it's a low, high ball up high, then the ball is behind you and you can't be very productive with it. Zabek with it on the far sideline. Throw in Lady Tigers. This is Lucet. Good throw. Bounced high, though. Still nobody has possession of it. Zabek says, I'll take possession of it. Did you see that nice little move that she's got there? My goodness. She's the best we've got in that area of the game. She just needs to maintain it and find a way to get it in the back of the net. Ball is served up, long, and coming out to grab it, Deanna Hassick. Hassick has two shutouts already this season. She's trying to maintain this one. Dwyer with a good use of the body as she blocked out the defender. Here's Willingham. Quick touch pass over to the other side. Sieber. Sieber has it stripped. She gets it back. She's going to throw it up to Willingham on the through ball, wide left of the net. And it's covered by Buckley, Aaliyah Buckley. Much better punt that time by Buckley. Much better punt. Loose ball towards the back. Hustling over to grab it. Lindsay Sechrist. Sechrist and her teammate, the goalkeeper, Hassick. You can pass the ball back to your own goalkeeper, but the goalkeeper may not pick it up with their hands if you have passed it with your feet. And that's why she played the ball forward on a kick there. If you head the ball back to your goalkeeper, she can grab it and then she can go ahead and play it. So we have a throw in for the Lady Tigers. That was Sechrist, as we said. She'll be playing at Hannibal LaGrange College. Playing the game she loves so much next year. It's so cool to see these kids get a chance to move on and play collegiately, get an opportunity to have part of their college expenses paid with scholarship. Here's Siebert, nice run. A little bit of a lean on the defender. I like it when they do that. That's all legal as long as the ball's at your feet. You can do that. Inbounds pass, Zadrovich catches up with it. Short pass, Siebert. Now this is Kirsten back into the game. Lady Tigers building from the back. Notice how they pass the ball back to their defenders. And then they move the ball forward. It gives you a chance to reposition some of your attackers if they're out of position chasing the ball down. It's called building from the back. And if you can do it well, oh, nice move, Kirsten. Nice move. Possession maintained. Defender fooled. There's a chip. High and over the goal. Got underneath it. When you're in that close, you want to lock your ankle, get your toe down, and slam your shot low and hard. Otherwise, it's just going to go up and over like that. sometimes if the goalkeeper is coming out to grab the ball, it's a good thing. It's a handy tool to chip the ball over the goalkeeper's head. But you don't want to put too much on it or it'll go over everything. Kirsten. Willingham. Henry. Loose ball. Who's going to grab it? Lady Tigers maintain possession. Waynesville is doing a much better job. Here is Zabek. Her cross was picked off, but she's going to get the ball back. Just kind of plays it wildly. Parkview comes up with it. Molly Henry dispossesses the Lady Viking. Loose ball. Kirsten off her chest to her feet. Forward. Gets it to Dwyer. Dwyer in the corner, and she could not turn it quite enough. Trying to cross the ball across, and you really need to turn your hips and collect the ball with the inside or the top of your foot for a quick cross like that. She didn't have her hips turned quite enough, and the ball consequently did not make a sharp 45-degree angle. Or 90-degree angle. It went more to 45. That's why I didn't teach math. Okay, ball to the feet of, I think that's Tate. Tigers hustling back on defense now. And they kind of let one get past them. And now, if you notice, it's going to be Parkview possession. We're going to have a change in goalkeeper for Parkview. And I'm not sure who the other goalkeeper is, as the Parkview roster does not have their positions on it. See if we can't figure out what uniform the young lady is wearing down there. She's got a number one on. And that would be, that's not Ellie Tate. That's not Ellie Tate. So maybe off the JV roster is, okay, I'm gonna say that's Yana Cloth, Yana Cloth, who started the JV game. So there's a foul against Parkview. And Waynesville's Zadrovich brings the ball out. Very, very poor attempt at possession that time for Parkview. Just stuck a leg out there. That doesn't help whatsoever. You have to have the touch. You have to learn the touch to keep the ball at your feet. Nice, nice throw, but it was over Siebert's head and right into a triangle. Siebert and Delaney Baker having a battle down there, and I think Siebert got the bad end of it, except that Baker couldn't maintain possession of the ball and kicked it out of bounds. So you see another throw in for Zadrovich. There it's deflected forward off the header by Willingham. Ball comes back. Here's Kirsten. Kirsten with a nice touch to beat somebody, beat the defender. And then the ball goes back to the center back and is cleared out. Kirsten again. This is Henry. Henry looking. And this is Sieber. Sieber with a through ball, but nobody's back there. The sweeper is the deep defender. And Waynesville can send somebody back as deep as that sweeper, and yet we're not. And so when we make a through ball, we don't have anybody deep to receive it. And that sweeper is just there to maintain possession of the ball, or retake possession of the ball, I should say. Long pass. It's just a clear, doesn't go anywhere. Lindsay Sechrist covers the ball, alertly gets it back to her goalkeeper. Hasek then brings it back out to Sechrist. Sechrist finds Zabek. Zabek this time loses the ball. And this is Lucet with a nice ball, but it's going to go out of bounds on the far side. So it'll be throw in with Maya Flores making the throw. There it is. Pretty good throw in. Possession is maintained by Parkview. Then they lose it, and then the ball is kicked out of bounds and not out of bounds. And it's just kicked down the line, and then it's going to be kicked out of bounds, and it'll be Waynesville ball. Should be Waynesville ball. What are we doing with it? Everybody's backing up. They're giving it back to Parkview? I guess they are. Okay, so Parkview with another throw in. Sometimes you can walk the ball all the way downfield with one throw in after another, and that gets dangerous. There's Lucet, and out of bounds off of, I think that's Tate. And then for no reason whatsoever, no reason whatsoever, she kicks the ball even farther back off of the playing field. That makes absolutely no sense in a game that you're losing 1-0 and you need to have possession of the ball, and you just lost about 10 seconds of playing time. Zabek trying to maintain possession. She beats two players, and then she went to the ground, and it's going to be a foul on the Parkview Lady Vikings. So Waynesville will have a direct kick up here just about where are they going to set the ball? You have to get it back just about right at midfield. You see the 50 there marked for football, and the black line extended past it. The midfield line for football and soccer are the same. Going to give it to Zadrovich, the opportunity to put the ball in play. There it is, long, downfield. There's Kirsten, loose ball. Zabek with a long shot high over the goal. Shot opportunity was there, and she took it, but it was a little bit too much. Lady Tigers holding on to a 1-0 lead. 13 minutes and 43 seconds to go in the game. It would be nice to get an insurance goal. Really would. But we have to be productive down close to the enemy's goal. That's it. Here's Zabek. She's triple teamed there. Nice through ball right into the hands of the goalkeeper. I think that was on goal. Sometimes it's difficult to see the angle as to whether or not the ball is collected by the goalkeeper to the inside or the outside of the post. Near midfield, ball's bouncing around. Parkview just gives a whack at it. Lucet works it to Hasek. She kicks the ball out. Parkview kind of nails it again. Now Waynesville nails it. We just need to pass it instead of nailing it. Lucet, and she beats her taller Parkview defender. That's Alyssa Laird, Amy Trin, a freshman off the JV team that's out there, number 19. Lucet leaned right past her. There's Lucet again. There, she beats somebody on the run. She's looking for somebody to pass to. She's going to lay it off to the outside. This is Zabek. Zabek with one to beat on the sideline. She's going to slow it down and kick it out of bounds. That would have been a pretty good opportunity for Zabek to simply have dropped it back behind her to the trailing defender. There should always be somebody behind you. But the way they're setting up out there, it looks like it's Waynesville's ball, so I guess it went off of the Parkview defender after Zabek touched it. On the throw in, Kirsten, Sieber, work. Shot, wide, I think it was deflected out. Are they gonna give us a goal kick on, or a corner kick on it? No. Nope, it was deflected off of one of the Lady Tigers. So it'll be a goal kick coming out. There it is, long. Almost possession, almost gained by Waynesville. And now Willingham has it, and she plays the ball back. The next touch by Waynesville is redirected out of bounds by Parkview. Inbounds on the throw in. Parkview kicks the ball down because Waynesville was unable to maintain possession of it. And it'll be out of bounds as they just kicked it once, one too many times, I should say, hard and out of bounds. So it'll be a goal kick coming. And a couple of the Lady Tigers down there talking things over. That's Lucet and Reagan Mertz. Mertz had a lot of touches early in the game. Not so many here in the second half. 10 minutes to go. 10 minutes to go. Need this win. Need this win. On the goal kick, it's coming right back at him. Lucet touches it out of bounds. This is going to give a throw in to Parkview at a very dangerous location. One of those players that can throw the ball long. This can be played pretty much like a corner kick. There's the long throw, but it's shorter than I thought it was. And Waynesville manages to get it cleared out. That's Zabek. Back at her. She plays it. Plays it down to her feet. Long, clear. And hustling out there to scoop it up is Deanna Hessig. Notice how she grabbed the ball inside the inside of both arms and hugged it to her chest with both hands. Really protects it that way. Can't hardly ever drop them when they're like that. Here we go, on a run. This is Zadrovich. She got one to beat. Off of her foot. It's going to go out of bounds. Off of who? Will be Waynesville ball. Waynesville ball as a throw-in. Zadrovich is coming up to take the throw. You'll see her running into the corner of the screen here right now. She has the ability to make it deep. I see one person short. I see another person almost in front of the goal mouth. There it is. Long and out of bounds off of Rodriguez. The ball initially went off the head of one of the Vikings, and Rodriguez, in the direction she was going, the ball just off her head and out of bounds. So another goal kick coming. I want to remind you that we have more Lady Tigers soccer tomorrow night right here at Tiger Stadium, as the Varsity Only will play St. Louis Hazelwood Central. Want to be here for that. This is Rodriguez. She took it off of the goal kick. Now Willingham. Willingham with the shot high and wide to the right over the head of the goalkeeper. If that was on target, she wouldn't have been able to handle it, and we'd have been up 2-0. But I like the fact that she didn't mess around with it. She got to it and took the shot. So goal kick coming out. Lady Tigers want possession. They do not want Parkview to come up with some kind of a surprisingly easy goal. They want to maintain possession and keep the ball in the attacking third if at all possible. That way you can also have the opportunity to just maybe get another goal. They are fighting for it out there. That was Kirsten and I think Tate. They've been battling. Out of bounds. Here's a restart opportunity. This is Zadrovic. You can see our sideline camera down there in the corner of the screen. There's a great shot. That's what we want. Look at that throw. Beautiful, beautiful. And yet we weren't able to capitalize on it. So Parkview going the other way. Under 7 to go in the game. Waynesville trying to manage a 1-0 lead, and this is going to be a foul, I think, on Emma Kirsten. Are they, did they call a throw-in? It is a throw-in. I guess it is a throw-in. Yep, Parkview thought it was going to be a direct kick. Your announcer thought it was going to be a direct kick, but that wasn't the case. It's a throw-in. Waynesville trying to find the ball. Zadovich got turned around behind her opponent. The ball bounced around over on the far sideline now. This is Waynesville's throw. They're going to give it to Lindsay Sechrist. Kirsten trying to get the ball to someone. Sechrist battling for it on the far side. And it's off of the Parkview freshman. So throw in wasn't real good. It was kind of an alley-oop throw. A lot of people can get underneath things like that. Try to direct your throw-ins, if at all possible, to your teammates' feet. And a foul that time on Christina Zabek as Daisy Brown went to the ground. So direct kick. This is from the Parkview side of the field. This is dangerous. And as Deanna Hassett gobbles it up. She saw what was happening and she hurried over there and grabbed it. And the Parkview attackers were a little bit sluggish on that. Getting to the point for Parkview that you just have to start taking some chances. Nice run down the sideline. This is Zabek. She's guarded by one person. She cuts back, left foot cross. This is Sieber. Sieber shot into the knee of an opponent, hustling over Kirsten. Kirsten overran the ball. She's trying to recover now as Parkview shovels the thing down the far sideline. You can see Tate hustling after it. If at all possible, she wants to try and get it. And I think it's going to be played off of her. Good head there by Lindsay Sechrist as she played the ball off of Tate, out of bounds, and then Sechrist got the throw in. So she was really using her head on that one. And now another throw in, or we have a foul. We have a foul, and so we will have the opportunity on the direct kick. This is Lucet. She can send it fairly long, but doesn't get a good piece of the ball that time. Willingham now back to one of the defenders, and they loft it deep and want to keep it down in the attacking third, but you don't want to just play kickball. You want to have the ball at your feet. You want to have possession of the ball. Just kicking it long doesn't help if you're going to lose possession of it. This is a good move by the Lady Tigers, Courtney Chartier. Throw in back to Parkview. Chest drop. Loose ball. It's kicked down long. And chasing it, Kirsten's going to try and catch up with it before it goes. No, that's Rodriguez. Rodriguez has the ball in play, but then she misplays it out of bounds. So it's going to go back to Parkview. 2:17 to go in the game. Waynesville up 1-0. Parkview trying to find the through ball, trying to find that lucky opportunity, trying to get the tying goal here. Waynesville has to defend strongly. This is Zadrovich. She's battling for the ball, and it's going to be no foul, no foul, and it will be out of bounds. It is a corner kick for Parkview. Corner kick coming up for Parkview. Under 2 minutes to go. Goal scoring opportunity for the Lady Vikings. You see Deanna Hassick out there. She's barking orders to her defense where she wants them. She's keeping most of the goal in front of her so that she can cover that the best. Coming down is the tall freshman. Here's the corner kick coming in from Maya Flores. And there it is. Knocked away by Hassick. Great defensive play. Knocked away by Hassick. And we have, I think, an official is going to call for to stop the clock. Yes. The clock is being stopped as we have an injury to Vanessa Neva. Neva holding her head. I'm not sure whether she ran into somebody else. Is she leaving the game? No, she's just walking back out with her teammates. They can make her leave the game since they stopped the clock. The officials are talking it over on the sideline. That's Sam Orr. He's the more experienced official. And sometimes they'll give a goalkeeper a break, but if they stop the signal, stop the clock for a field player, they very often make the player leave the game. Not so. We're going to go ahead with another corner kick. A minute 7 to go. You saw it on the clock. It's at the bottom of your screen. Here it comes. It is not a good corner kick. It is going to be knocked out of bounds again by a Waynesville defender. And so we will have our third corner kick in a row. This can be dangerous. In the air. Headed out of bounds. Headed out of bounds. Off the head of the Parkview defender and lost it out of bounds instead of turning it on to the goal. When that ball's coming in, you have to use your head and you have to direct it right or left, and they just let it ball go straight out. 33 seconds to go. Bad goal kick right to the Parkview players out of bounds. Another corner kick coming. Hasek is shouting at her teammates. The clock is running. This is Parkview's ball. Now they have it planted on the far sideline. They're trying to get it going. There it is with 4 seconds to go. Hasek knocks it away, and that's it. That's it. The shot came after the end of the game, and that is it. The Waynesville Lady Tigers have defeated Springfield Parkview here tonight. 1-0. Waynesville goes to 4-7 on the season. The Lady Tigers also now 3-2 in Ozark Conference play, and they are 2-1. They finished 2-1 against their district opponents, and Parkview drops to 1-2. So it's a very good possibility, or it should be, that Waynesville will receive the 2 seed in the district, and most likely, since Lebanon is already 0-2 and has lost to Parkview, that means that Waynesville and Parkview will match up again in the opening round of district play. But that's not for over a month ahead of us. Lady Tigers were the better team out there tonight. We saw a lot of possession. They didn't maintain it for a very, very long time, but they were able to be more productive with it and keep the ball at their feet, connecting some passes, and as I said, maintain possession of the ball. The only goal of the game came with 14 minutes and 41 seconds remaining in the first half, and it was off of the foot of Nina Grace Rodriguez. And that was her first goal for the Lady Tigers this year. Waynesville continues to struggle offensively. 5 goals in 11 games. That's it. Just 5 goals in 11 games. Reminder that Waynesville Varsity will play here tomorrow night against St. Louis Hazelwood Central. The Lady Hawks have been coming down here now for about 7 or 8 years on Friday nights, and we've had some luck against them, and they've had some luck against us. So it's going to be a treat for all of you Tiger fans that come out. And if you enjoyed the game on Cable Channel 12 tonight, please be here tomorrow night. I think that the varsity-only game starts at 5 o'clock. So come here and get ready to cheer these girls on against the St. Louis Ball Club. Ladies and gentlemen, this has been a Channel 12 TV production. The following faculty and students worked tonight. Tim Wallace was our R6 district programmer. And the students that worked with him on the cameras and in the direction booth was Jordan Hinchman, Tatum Brown, Jonathan Bogart, Travis Turner, Duncan Pitts, Alex McEachern, and Grace Foxworth. And I had a wonderful time bringing you the game here on Cable Channel 12. I'm Nelson Morgan, and I do hope to see you here tomorrow night when the Lady Tigers take on Hazelwood Central. Thank you for tuning in.